Hi, welcome again to our YouTube channel. Today we'll review another pen from our collection, the Parker Centennial Dufault Classic Black. As the Parker Dufault Classic Vintage Red we already reviewed, this one comes inside the same kind of box. You have to pull this tab to open the box. Inside you have a card talking about Dufault with a window where you can see the cap of the pen. You pull this tab and take the card out, and you have the booklet and two ink cartridges, and here you pull this tab and you take the pen out of the box. Let's put this aside and talk about the pen. As you can see, this is a black pen with a silver color trim. Parker calls these the Parker Centennial Dufault Classic Premium Satin Black. It is a very long name. So, as you can see, this is black, shiny. It is made of acrylic, as some other Dufaults. Now there are also metal Dufaults. It has, let's focus closer. It has the modern medallion on the top of the cap, with the Ace of Spades and beneath Dufault written, and the clip as usual with this Dufault, modern Dufault pens, it has this arrow shaped clip. On the bottom of the cap there is a quite wide band with two horizontal lines, and inside the horizontal lines there is the most recent Parker logo, the Parker name of the company, and then France. There is also a ring at the end of the barrel, and unlike previous versions of this pen, this one has no, sorry, this is because of the background, this pen has no date code engraved here on this last part of the barrel. Also, this ring is flat all around and leveled with the surface of the barrel, and not rounded and rounded and coming off the surface of the pen as it used to happen with older versions. Maybe I'll get one just to show you. Here you have, I don't know if this, I'll try to focus closer to see it. Okay, so here I don't think we'll be able to see this. This metal ring on the white pen is as a round surface, it's like this. This is much exaggerated with this action, but it's like this. And this one is flat into the surface. And maybe here you can see. It's quite different in this point. This one, which is the older one, I don't know if you can see here with the light, has the date code engraved here. This one has not. Okay, let's move on. The cap. Sorry, I have to focus this. The cap screws off, and you have a section, a wide section. You have a big nib. This section has a almost like a hourglass shape, and it is very comfortable to hold. The nib is made of 18 karat gold and is a two-colored nib with this central golden part of the ace of spades. It has Dufold engraved and then Parker 18K and 750, which is the same as 18K. And underneath we have a flat feed without no visible fins, and here it is the grade of the nib F. Inside, the section threads are made of metal, as you can see, and here it has engraved, I'll try to show you, France, and then it has a serial number. We don't really know if this is a serial number or if it is some kind of date code. If any of the viewers know what this is, please tell us on the comments. We would like to know more about this. The filling system, as you saw when I opened the pen, is the proprietary Parker cartridges or converter, and this pen comes with a converter. About the pen, this is a very nice sized pen. I would say this is a big pen. It fits well even on larger hands. It's very, very comfortable to hold. It can be posted, and it posts securely, but it doesn't post very deep, so it gets a little back heavy, not so comfortable at all. But because I usually write with holding the cap in my left hand and writing with my right hand, it's perfect like this. The grip is very comfortable because it is wide enough to be held like this and not squeezing the fingers too much over each other. So let's see how it writes with a short writing test. As usual, we are using the Rodia dot pad, and I'll focus a little better if I can. And the ink is Diamine Violet, and the pen, as you already know, is the Parker Duofold. Sorry, just trying to focus. Is the Parker Duofold Classic, very long name, Premium Satin Black with a F nib. The pen writes really, really well. Here it didn't because I changed the angle, but the pen writes really well. It is wet enough, not too much, but it's not dry. You can see it smears, but not too much. It's a really nice pen. It is wider than, for example, Japanese F, but it's acceptable as a regular F. We find this top of line Parker nibs to be really good, and the grade of the nib is more close to reality than the nibs on cheaper pens. And this pen, this nib is not flexible, although it allows for some line variation, as you can see, but you have to apply a lot of pressure and maybe get to damage the nib, and here it even skip. So it's not a flexible pen at all. The nib is really, really, really smooth, although it is Parker smooth, which means it's not a buttery smooth pen. You feel some feedback, but not very much. Much less than the feedback of a Japanese pen, for example. But there is some... I call this a Parker smooth pen. In our opinion, this Parker Dufold, these are... or any other Parker Centennial Dufold, because of its size, this one or this one or this one, for example, are perfect pens for writing a long novel with. They are very comfortable, heavy enough, long, wide. They are very nice pens to write with. The only problem is the price, but sometimes you can find these as unwanted gifts at some secondhand shops. I hope you liked this review. Thank you for watching, and please subscribe our channel and follow our blog. See you next time. I hope soon. Bye.